I still prefer to smoke joints. I never could smoke cigarettes, and when the whole blunt thing came in, I just never got into it. I couldn't roll. I can't, still to this day, I don't roll blunts. I still don't like the taste of tobacco, and the blunts to me just cover the taste of weed. I mean, I'm a weed connoisseur. I like smoking good tasting weed. I look for good marijuana, and to me, putting them in a Dutch, putting them in a blunt, putting them in a Swisher covers up the taste of good marijuana. So for me, a joint or a bowl.
May 18, 2013. Philadelphia Police Department and Federal Park Police charged into this rally, this peaceful smoke down that occurs on Independence Mall in front of the Liberty Bell, in front of Independence Hall, wherever the Constitution Center is, right in the sacred ground of where American liberty was created, was founded, was first thought of, was signed into law, the creation of America. Like, that exact same spot is where the Reefer Revolution just began. Welcome to the Reefer Revolution. Every time I try to stop actively being an activist, something happens, you know? And this time, here it was April 15th, 2013. I was simply a passenger in a car, driving. I got pulled over by the Esham Township Police Department. They said there was a light out. They checked the driver, and, you know, everything was good. But anyway, at some point, they stopped focusing on the driver. This was a simple traffic stop, but the police decided to focus on me. I was wearing a shirt that had a marijuana leaf on it, and apparently the officer felt that was enough probable cause to search me and search the car. He pulled me out of the car, and he executed the search, and just about any time, I've got a little bit of marijuana on me. You know, and I had a bottle similar to this. With a couple joints worth of marijuana. Anyway, they charged me. That was on April 15th. Next thing you know, it was headlines in the newspaper again. And I was forced once again by the actions of the police to defend myself. You know, a lot of times people are constantly thinking that I'm out there causing problems and this, that, and the other. You know, I defend myself when attacked. And that's all it was, to be honest with you. You know, this is my medicine. I use marijuana medicinally. But how I responded this time also made headlines. This is an editorial by Jeff Edelstein where he explains that how I had filed this challenge brief. You go to my website, njweedman.com/challenge.pdf. That's where I filed this challenge brief, and I put it online, I put it out there so anyone can see it and read it, and I sent it to the newspapers, I sent the links to it, but I'm tired of being this one-man gang always fighting for this cause that I believe thousands of people across the country, across New Jersey, agree on. And the one thing in New Jersey's law is wrong. And this PDF argues that point, or presents that argument. The argument is that on one hand, New Jersey describes marijuana as a dangerous, addictive, having no medical need or benefit, Schedule 1 drug. That's how our criminal statutes describe marijuana. Then we have this new law, the New Jersey Medical Marijuana Compassionate Use Act of 2010, which describes marijuana as having medical value, as having usefulness in treating symptoms of, say, cancer. And this law allows people to distribute it, possess it, and use it. But here in New Jersey, people are still being charged under the criminal statute. And I believe that the Marijuana and the Compassionate Use Act nullified and voided out the criminal marijuana statutes in New Jersey. And this motion that I filed, that's being talked about publicly and put on the internet, is my legal argument to that. And I could present that argument myself. Several times I've had cases dismissed administratively because I filed a challenge to the scheduling of marijuana as having no medical value. Now, at this point, the state of New Jersey agrees with me, even. I think there's a no-brainer, it's a win, but this isn't just about me, so I put this brief out online so that hundreds of people, I hope dozens of people at least, file this brief in the state courts across New Jersey. And let's see what happens, let's see if any judge is brave enough, willing, to buck the status quo and dismiss based on these legal arguments.